Better. Hey y'all, it's Steen B and I'm back again with another video. Basically, this video was about being a yeoman, if I like it, how it is, and all that good stuff. I'm gonna give y'all the tea. And I know y'all thinking like, who she thinks she is? She got a whole blazer on, period. But yeah, I'm gonna get into that video, and it is hot, so let me take this off. All right, y'all, let's get into it. So I'm gonna start off by like explaining how I even got the rate, you know, and then we're just gonna get into it. Okay, so I got the rate. Okay, first of all, my rate has changed so many times. Like when I was in debt, they changed my rate so many times. Like first I was an OS, then I was aviation. I was just everything. And then last rate was Yeoman, and my recruiter was like, you know, since you wanna go to school and all that, a Yeoman is a really good job because it's easy. And yeah, he convinced me to do Yeoman, and I took it. And I really didn't know what it was at the time. I researched it. I'm like, Yeoman, the name don't even sound right. So I researched it, and I did my research, and I'm like, okay, it don't sound bad, you know. I'm going to have my own little office space and all that. So I'm like, okay, cool. I took it. So while being boot camp, people will discourage you about being a Yeoman. People will do that. They'll be like, what's your rate? And you'll say Yeoman. They'll be like, Yeoman. Like, it was even an instructor at boot camp that was like, the two worst rate in the Navy is Yeoman and something else. In my head, I'm like, how? They was like, because they don't do nothing. But people really don't know. We're the backbone to it all. Like, we do everything. Anything that we mess up with, it affects you guys. Like, you know, service members. But yeah, like, people overlook Yeoman. Like, oh, it's just paperwork. You don't even know. You don't even need to go to school for that. And I used to believe it until I got to A school. So if you're a yeoman, yes, it's not aviation and all that, but that is a good rate in my opinion. Like, you do so much. It's so much to it that people don't know. People just say, oh, office work, you know. But yeah, I so far I like being a yeoman. I ain't gonna lie. It's cool. All right, so other than that, let's get into A school. So A school, yeoman A school. So the first day we got there and we jumped into it because it's 5 weeks. The school is 5 weeks and three tests. And it's just a lot of information to take in 5 weeks. Like a lot. It was a lot. Like I had two notebooks. Everything was filled up by the time I was done. Excuse me, I need some water. But yeah, like it is a lot because it is a lot of references. It's a lot of forms because you work directly under the CO. And like, everything you do for your command and your CO. It's a lot of paperwork, you know, processing stuff. It's really a lot. But once you know your stuff, you're set. Like, you just gotta memorize your references and all that. But, like, Yeoman in school, it isn't hard. It's not hard. And it's not easy also. You have to be dedicated. You have to study. You have to ask questions when you don't, ouch. You have to ask questions when you don't understand stuff. I got a fresh tattoo. Look at it. It's so nice. Okay. Little story. I know I'm not supposed to be talking about this, but my new tattoo, and you know, I was born in Africa, so I got the little Africa continent, and say made in Africa with a butterfly, and then it's fingerprints. These are fingerprints because I was made in Africa. Anyway, back to story. I'm sorry. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so you're my A school. You have to study. You have to be determined. Ask questions, you know, because it is a lot to intake, and sometimes you might not understand it at first. But 5 weeks of the Yeoman A school was nothing. Like, that's just the basic. That's just the basic. That's not everything to being a yeoman. So don't be like, oh, okay, that's it. Like, you're going to learn so much more. It's going to be so much more training. You do with travel stuff, awards. Like, everything that happens, you're the one that makes it happen. So you got to be on point with your game. You cannot bullshit. But, let me open my notebook because I be forgetting my questions and stuff. Or, you know, one second. Okay, so basically a yeoman is like, you're working in the admin office, administration, you're filling out paperwork, you're filing, you're doing awards, you're doing travel, you're doing everything that needs. I'm trying to make this video, but people keep interrupting me. I don't understand. Like, okay, like I was saying, now I have an attitude. Like I was saying, I'm hurt. Being a yeoman, you have to be on your shit because your command heavily weighs on you. Well, relies on you. Let me use a strong choice of word. Your command relies on you to get things done. You know, you're going to be doing a lot of paperwork, processing, filing, it's more to it than you think. It's not just a basic office work, no. And the hours, like, at my command, the hours is from 7 to 16, sometimes 8 to 15, all depends. But, like, typically that's your working day. But for real, you could be there later. You can always be there as late as freaking 9 o'clock. It all depends on your command. And you do not leave before your CO leave. It's just that. But my experience at A school, like, it was cool, you know. They just went over all the references that you need to know. It's a lot. You will memorize it, but, you know, it's there for you. That's how you refer to things and get things done. You use your references. And while taking a test, we had 3 tests at Yeoman A school, and you could use your references. You can't use your notes. You can use your references. So you still have to study and know, okay, so this topic goes with this reference. So I go look in this reference to get the answer. You know, that's how we took our test, you know. If you didn't study, you was just looking at every reference for the answer. You have to study and get familiar with your references, you know. So that was basically it. My instructors, they were pretty cool. Like, I like their teaching skills. I understand it more. And yeah, there's only 3 tests, but in my opinion, they're changing the curriculum anyway. They're changing it, so the curriculum we went with, it might be completely different, so I can't even speak on it. But Yeoman A school is just basic, the most basic thing of a Yeoman. When you get to your command, you're still learning, you're still in training, because there's more to it, you know, and some things we didn't even cover in Yeoman A school. But hold up, let me check my notebook. I'll be losing my train of thought. Damn. So me personally, I like being a Yeoman. I think being a Yeoman, you know, I just like that I get to be my own little boss in a way. Like, I have my own office space. And, you know, you always have to follow chain of command. There's always someone on top of you. But I just like having my own little office space, my own little computer decorated, and typing. I like typing. I like technology. So my job, including all of that, that's what I like about it. I told y'all how Yeoman A school was. I told y'all why I chose it. And so far, I like it. I have not got to my first command yet to tell you anything about being a Yeoman in the fleet. So I cannot speak on that because I haven't been in the fleet yet. I'm on leave right now, so I'll be there in a couple of weeks. But I'll make an updated video about it. But I have not got into my first command yet to tell y'all about being a Yeoman. And I know it's not a... I know it's not a lot of Yeoman videos, because when I was joining, I'm over here typing it up on YouTube, searching it up, Yeoman videos, how is it like being a Yeoman, stuff like that, and I could not find anything. Anything I found was like over 10 years old, and I'm like, nah. So that's why I make my YouTube video. Like, I want to help people, because I know when I was about to join, I wanted to know what I was signing myself up for. And yeah. So that brings me to the last thing. How can you being a Yeoman benefit you in the civilian world? Good question, my friend. So being a Yeoman, you have to remember, Yeoman is administration work. So everything you do in the office, that's Yeoman. So say you retire and, you know, you want to get a job in the civilian world, and you was a Yeoman before. You can work in hospitals. You can work in freaking any office. You can even work in law firms. Like, you can be freaking so many things. Like, don't just think, oh, Yeoman, that's all. Like, no, it's so many things, because you have experience of everything an office maintenance does. You have experience in all of that. So anywhere in the civilian world, you can type, you know how to set your references, you have experience filing, all that stuff. It's more to it. I'm just naming with the top of my head. But you can get a job in a civilian world like this. Like, and you will have qualification for so many things. And you'll be certified in so many things. So, like, I know me, God, I said God forbid. If I decided to, you know, leave the Navy, I can get a job anywhere. I was a Yeoman. Like, I'm still set, you know. Don't just think, okay, it only benefits me if I'm in the Navy. No, it benefits you everywhere. You can get a job anywhere. Yeah, so I know some of you guys are about to join the Navy, especially get ready to Yeoman, and you have so many questions, like, how is it like and all that. And I'm just giving you guys advice and my experience, how it went down with me. So far, I do like being a yeoman. I enjoy it, and I feel like it'll be better once I get in the fleet. But pretty much, I would say, like, go determined. You know what you want to do. Even if this is not the right for you, just be open-minded. You never know. Like, guys are yeomen. Don't think, oh, I'm a yeoman, I'm a guy. Like, I had this guy in boot camp. I met him, and he was like, he was in THU, and he was like, yeah, I've been in THU for 6 months. I'm like, why? He was like, because he changed his rate. I'm like, why? He was like, because I'm a yeoman. That was a bitch job. I was like, excuse me? Like, people look down on yeomans, and it cracks me up because we handle your shit. Like, if I fuck up, it ain't a life or death situation, but it can affect you, which I won't. I'm just saying. But yeah, like, he changed his rate because he thought being a yeoman was a bitch job. Anybody can be a yeoman. Oh yeah, and being a yeoman, we have flag riders. If you're a flag rider, you're working for admirals. Like, you're working for higher ups. You're traveling with them and doing everything with them. Like, you're their personal secretary. So yeoman has so much more to it. Don't just hear the little word yeoman and just be like, okay. Like, it's so much more to it. You can be so much. You can be a yeoman on a submarine. You can be a yeoman in a warfare environment. You could be a yeoman anywhere. Everybody needs yeoman because we're just necessities, you know? But basically, that's it. When you go to A school, take notes. Be determined. Ask questions if you don't understand it. And be open-minded. That's my things. That's what I have to give to y'all. Any more questions y'all have, hit me up. You know I'm down. You don't. I'm cracking up. But yeah, like, that's basically it, man. So basically, that's it about being a yeoman that I can think of off the top of my head. If you guys have any more questions about yeoman, whatever it may be, comment below. I'm here for you guys because I was once searching out questions about the military and being a yeoman because I was joining. So I know how it is. I feel y'all. And it's not enough videos to help us out here. That's why I'm here. So like and subscribe for more. And yeah, it's Dean V.